हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे विल मेक एग बिरयानी। दिस इज़ द सिंपल रेसिपी ऑफ बिरयानी एंड दिस एग बिरयानी यू कैन मेक व्हेन एवर यू आर फीलिंग लेजी बट यू वांट टू ईट सम गुड फूड। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल मेक गरम मसाला। फॉर दैट वी नीड 1 टेबल स्पून फनेल सीड, 1 टेबल स्पून क्यूमिन सीड्स, फ्यू पेपर कॉर्न, 1 ब्लैक कैडमम, यू कैन टेक इट विथ स्किन और विदाउट स्किन, and 3 green cardamom, 1 piece of cinnamon, 5 to 6 pieces of cloves and 2 small bay leaves. Just dry roast all these ingredients and grind it to fine powder to make the garam masala. This garam masala I use for most recipes, like all non-veg recipes, so you can make it in more quantity also. Next I am going to take 8 boiled eggs. With that I am going to take 1/2 tablespoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste, handful of chopped coriander leaves, handful of chopped mint leaves, and 1 tablespoon of lemon juice, 1/2 cup of curd, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder, and 1.5 tablespoon of biryani masala. Any biryani masala you can take, brand doesn't matter, but if you don't have biryani masala you can take 2 tablespoon of garam masala. Now we'll add all the ingredients to the egg and we'll marinate the egg. We'll leave the egg for 1/2 hour to 1 hour so that the flavor of all masala will get inside the egg. And before marination, do not forget to give some slits in your egg so that the masala will get inside the egg. In this biryani, the main ingredient is your garam masala powder and the fried onions. If you have biryani masala then it's well and good, but if you don't have biryani masala, just replace your biryani masala with garam masala. Here I am adding only 1 teaspoon of chili powder, but while cooking I'll add some more Kashmiri red chili powder for color. And this is my homemade garam masala which I have shown you at the beginning. Just to dry roast all the ingredients I have shown and then grind it to fine powder. I usually make it in lot because I use it a lot. So now I am going to add the biryani masala and after that we'll mix it all. This biryani recipe doesn't take long time, and if you have sudden guest at home you can plan for this biryani. Here I am going to add 1 teaspoon of coriander powder and 1/2 teaspoon of cumin powder, but this is optional. If you want you can add, if you don't want you can skip. If you don't have fresh mint leaves you can add dried mint leaves or kasuri methi, it depends on you. And now we will soak 2 cups of rice. Before soaking your rice you should wash it, because after soaking if you wash then the rice will break, so definitely wash it before soaking. So now I'll just make my fried onion. I prefer making it at home because I have noticed in the market, but fried onions there is lots of cornstarch. So I have cut 1 big size onion into thin slices and I fried it on medium heat till it's light golden brown, and then I'll take it out. It depends on you whether you want to make your fried onions at home or you want to use the market bought one. Whenever I prepare rice for biryani, I prefer making my rice in a pot with lots of water, and after that I strain all the water. But if you don't want, you can cook your rice in rice cooker. If you are using rice cooker, then just take 1.5 cup of water for 1 cup of rice, because you have already soaked it. So now I have taken lots of water, I added salt to it, and then I am going to add my rice. I'll just cook it for maximum 4 to 5 minutes. Now in a non-stick pot I have added 3 tablespoons of oil and few bay leaves, some green cardamom, some cloves, 1 piece of cinnamon, and then I am going to add some chopped onion. I have taken half of a medium size onion chopped, and I am going to fry it till it is light golden brown, and after that we'll add our egg. Now you can see my rice is half cooked, and now I'll strain all the water. We are not going to cook the rice fully, otherwise when we will make the biryani our rice will be overcooked. So I strained water from the rice, and now I'm going to put my egg to the oil. My onion is already fried, so put the egg, just cook it for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes I can smell the raw smell of masala is gone. I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of turmeric and 1/2 cup of water, so that I can cook it for another 5 minutes, so that the spices will go inside the egg and nice flavor will come out of it. And now it is cooked. It took exactly 10 minutes. Now I am going to bring down the heat around 3 and 3.5. You can make it seem if you are cooking on gas. And now I am going to spread all rice at a time on top of the egg curry. If you have lots of rice, you can make 2 layers of rice, but here I have cooked only 2 cups of rice, so I'll make only 1 layer. And few people use food coloring for the biryani, but I'm going to put some chopped beetroots for the coloring, because I prefer to use all natural things. So beetroot will bring nice color to your biryani and it's healthy. And some chopped coriander leaves. If you have mint leaves, you can add some more fresh mint leaves here. And some black cumin or Shahi Zeera, you can put it here. And some dried mint leaves I'm going to put, because I don't have fresh mint leaves anymore, so you can put dried mint leaves also. I just crushed the dried mint leaves in my palm, and I'll take out the sticks, and then I'll add the fried onion. If you are making 2 layers of rice, you can give your second layer after giving all these things. And on top of this we'll add milk. If you want to add saffron or food color, just heat your milk, add saffron and food color to the milk, and then add the milk to the biryani. Now cover the biryani and cook it on low heat for 20 to 25 minutes. And after that we'll check, there should not be any gravy under the rice. After 20 minutes I'm going to switch off the burner, and I will check whether there is any gravy at the bottom of the pan or not. It's totally dry, there is no gravy at the bottom of the pan, so it is done. But I won't mix it now, I'll just cover it for another 5 minutes, so that the rice will come out very nice. See, now the rice won't break. If it is too hot, you will break all the rice if you mix it immediately. Now my biryani is done. I am going to serve it with raita. You can serve it with any kind of non-veg curry or salan. So try this recipe in any weekend or weekdays and let me know how it came out. Subscribe to my channel to get new recipes, and press the bell button to get the notifications.